हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल स्टडी द चैप्टर नंबर 10, दैट इज़ माइक्रोब्स इन ह्यूमन वेलफेयर. नाउ वी नो दैट देयर आर वेरियस टाइप ऑफ माइक्रोब्स, द माइन्यूट ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच कांट सी देम विदाउट एनी एड लाइक माइक्रोस्कोप एट्सेट्रा. एंड सम ऑफ दीज माइक्रोब्स आर बैक्टीरिया, प्रोटोजोआ, फंगाई, प्लांट एंड एनिमल वायरसेस, वायरॉइड्स, प्रायंस एट्सेट्रा. And some of these microbes are useful for us and utilized in various activities for human welfare. Some of these microbes play very important role in household activities, then industrial production, as a biocontrol agent, as biofertilizer, in biogas production, in various types of antibiotics, medicines, vaccines, etc. So we will discuss some of the beneficial activities of these microbes. First of all, we will start with microbes in household activities. Like some of the bacteria or the other microorganisms are utilized in household activities, like number one, that is lactic acid bacteria or lab bacteria. It can convert milk into curd, which is rich in vitamin B12 or cyanocobalamin and very highly nutritious for our digestive system. Other microorganisms which are helping us in household activities is baker's yeast or Saccharomyces cerevisiae. These yeast are responsible for fermenting the dough, which dough can be utilized for making bread, idli, dosa, and some other food products. Some of the drinks like toddy and other drinks, as well as for the fermentation of soya bean, fish, etc., these yeasts are utilized. Now the cheese are made by the help of these bacteria. One of the bacteria, that is Propione bacterium charomani, helps in making the Swiss cheese have large holes due to the production of large amount of CO2. Other type of cheese is known as Roquefort cheese, which is ripened by growing a specific fungi on them with a specific flavor. So in this way, we can see these are some examples of the microorganisms which are helping us in household activities. The microbes benefits us in various ways, by various activities. For example, we can see here that bacteria are primary decomposers. That means they recycle the nutrients back into the environment and thus helps in sewage treatment plants. Then microbes produces various food products like cheese, pickle, then green olives, yogurt, soya sauce, vinegar, bread, beer, wine, alcohol. That means various type of things which are made by or helped by this bacteria or the yeast, etc. That is different types of microbes. Now in nowadays we are utilizing the biotechnology for our betterment of the life. Like biotechnology, the aim of the biotechnology is to increase the production of proteins, amino acid, vitamins and antibiotics by the help of microorganisms, and these microorganisms are used in cleaning the environment also, waste management also, at the same time biodiesel formation from the plants. So in this way we can see that the microbes play very important role in our life. In this slide we can see the microorganisms which are utilized in household products, like the microorganisms like lactobacillus. We can see here these are lactobacillus which are helping in converting the milk into the curd. Then the dough, dosa, idli fermented by bacteria, the puffed appearance occurs due to the production of CO2 gas, and which is done by the bacteria. These bacteria are utilized for fermenting the dough, and so that we can make various type of food products. Then baker's yeast is also utilized in the formation or fermentation of the dough and other things. Here are the some examples of microbes. Like here we can see in the figure, that is lactobacillus, then lab bacteria, then what are the importance of this curd for our digestive system. They actually, the lab bacteria produces acid which coagulate and partially digest the milk proteins, and it improves the nutritional quality by increasing vitamin B12 or the cyanocobalamin. And in our stomach too, the lab play very important role in checking disease causing microbes. In this way, these microbes helping us. In this slide we can see the use of microbes, how they are utilized in the formation of industrial products. Now the microbes are utilized in formation of fermentation of this beverages, then antibiotics, then formation of synthesis of enzymes, chemicals, bioactive molecules, etc. Now for fermented beverages, the yeast that is known as Saccharomyces cerevisiae is utilized, and this yeast will do the process of fermentation of cereals, fruit juice, etc., and it will produce ethanol. Now this ethanol will undergo the processing, and depending upon the processing method, whether with the distillation or without distillation, different products are produced. Like with distillation, whiskey, brandy and rum, and without distillation, wine and beers are produced. Now formation of different types of antibiotics in the field of pharmaceuticals. Antibiotics means against life. Anti means against, and biotics means life. So when the pathogen enter in our body, which are responsible for various types of disease, they can be killed by the use of these antibiotics. The first antibiotic which was discovered by Alexander Fleming was named as penicillin by the fungi that is known as, from the source was fungi that is Penicillium notatum, during 1944-45, during the Second World War. That time the wounded soldiers were treated by these antibiotics, and hence in the year of 1945, Fleming, Chain and Flore, these three scientists got the Nobel Prize. Nowadays, different various types of antibiotics are produced by the help of biotechnology, rDNA technology, etc. Now, the production of enzymes, chemicals and bioactive molecules are also done by these bacteria. In this slide, we can see how the glucose will undergo the fermentation process to produce the pyruvate, and this will undergo the process of fermentation by the help of different types of microbes like Aspergillus, Lactobacillus, Saccharomyces, and the products are, see here, lactic acid is produced by this Aspergillus. Then Lactobacillus will give rise to the formation of the lactic acid, and that lactic acid will produce cheese, yogurt, etc. Then Saccharomyces cerevisiae will undergo the process of help in the process of fermentation, and will produce beer, wine, bread, etc. In this slide we can see the production of the penicillin from the fungi that is Penicillium notatum. This is the Penicillium notatum plant, a mold that is fungi, and the scientist how they form, isolate this, and will form the antibiotic, and this antibiotic medicine will be helping all the different types of patients in various activities, various disorders. In this slide we can see the medicinal use of the microorganisms, how they are utilized in the field of pharmaceuticals, medicinal purposes. See, in medicine, the penicillium, which was discovered by Alexander Fleming in 1928 and produced by the fungus Penicillium notatum, and it is one of the most commonly used antibiotics nowadays. Now, vaccines are discovered by Edward Jenner in 1796, usually made from weak or inactive versions of the same microbes that make us ill. The microbes play a very major role in development and production of future medicine like vaccines, antibiotics, etc. And microbes have played a significant role in the development of medical treatments also. These medicines are made in the form of capsules, tablets, injections, etc. And by the help of these antibiotics, these medicines kill or stop the growth of disease-causing microbes. Some of the examples are streptomycin, tetracycline, erythromycin. The enzymes are also produced by the help of different types of microbes. For example, lipase, streptokinase, protease, these are some enzymes which are produced by the help of the microbes. Lipase is utilized in the detergent formulation or the removal of the oily stain in the laundry. Streptokinase, which is obtained by the bacteria Streptococcus, is utilized as clot buster. That means removal of the clot from the blood vessels, hence they can help the heart patients. Then protease enzyme is help in the bottling process. That means the fruit juice can make clearer so that the economic value becomes more. Now the chemicals, some like organic acids, are also produced by the help of the microorganisms. For example, citric acid, acetic acid, lactic acid, butyric acid, ethanol, etc. Now citric acid is produced by the fungi Aspergillus niger. Acetic acid is produced by the bacteria Acetobacter acetae, and lactic acid is produced by the bacteria Lactobacillus. At the same time, butyric acid is produced by the bacteria Clostridium butylicum, and ethanol is produced by the yeast, that is fungi Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Then the bioactive molecules are cyclosporine A and statin. The source of this cyclosporine A is the Trichoderma polysporum, and its function is that it acts as the immunosuppressive agent. That means during organ transplantation, this cyclosporine A help the process of organ transplantation as immunosuppressive agent. Now statin is another this product, bioactive molecules, which help in the lowering down of the blood cholesterol. That means the blood cholesterol level will go down because it will inhibit the activity of the enzyme which are responsible for the synthesis of cholesterol. The source of this statin is Monascus purpureus. In this slide we can see some of the examples of the enzymes which we have already learned, that is lipase, which is used in the laundry detergents, then pectinase and protease used in bottled juices, then streptokinase used as clot buster to remove the blood clots from the blood vessel and helps the heart patients. Now statin is used in the lowering of blood cholesterol. Cyclosporine A act as the immunosuppressive agent and help in organ transplantation. Streptokinase clot from the blood vessels, lipase removal of oil stains. Now the next area field in which the microbes are helping, that is in sewage treatment. That means the municipal waste water, whatever the municipal waste coming out from the household activities from the township, can be when it will mix up with the water bodies, they will pollute the whole water body and become toxic for the aquatic animals too. So that the municipal wastewater should be purified before the mixing with the water bodies, and this is known as sewage treatment. Now the sewage treatment occurs in two major steps. First step is primary sewage treatment and second is secondary sewage treatment. In primary sewage treatment, this is known as physical process, and secondary sewage treatment biological process, because here the living organisms or the bacteria and other microbes are helping in this process. Now the physical process, it includes two steps, that is filtration and sedimentation, in which the large and small particles are removed. Filtration occurs by the help of the mess made of net made up of different size messes, which occurs in different steps. Then after the filtration, that water is sent to the tank, sedimentation tank, with a grit made up of, and at the bottom grit is made, and that's why it is allowed for the settle. After settling down the sedimented water, the all water will come up, that is known as effluent, and the sediment which is settled down will be known as primary sludge. Now this effluent will send to the next tank that is made for the secondary sewage treatment, where there are two types of bacteria are there. Aerobic bacteria, they will act upon that, and that they will make a flock. That means the bacteria as well as fungi will grow, and they will make a cluster, that is known as flock. They will consume the organic waste in the water, and after their death they will make the activated sludge. These and the effluent is now sent to the next chamber, where the anaerobic bacteria act upon that and they will produce the gas known as biogas, which is the mixture of methane, CO2 and H2. In this way the primary and secondary sewage treatment takes place, and after that that water will allow in the water bodies to mix up. Here the Ganga Action Plan and Yamuna Action Plan are doing a lot in this field. This slide is showing the steps of primary and secondary treatment, sewage treatment. Here primary treatment, here raw sewage is there. Through the screen it will undergo the process of filtration as well as sedimentation. Here filtration will go on. Here grit chamber is there, where the this sedimentation will occur. And now this effluent, is primary effluent, will send to this adjacent tank, where the flock bacteria as well as fungi will grow, and that will consume the organic matter here. Now after that it will send to the next, that is secondary effluent will send for the next process, that is known as sludge treatment as well as disposal. And finally the purified water is sent for discharge to the surface water or tertiary treatment. So these are the step of the sewage treatment.